Yo, what is going on, guys? Before we dive into this week's podcast, I just want to say thank you to everyone showing love. Make sure to hit that like button, comment, and subscribe on next week's podcast. If we reach 30 likes on this week's podcast, I will be rolling an ounce blunt and be doing a podcast. All right, let's dive into it. Let's go. Yo, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. It is your boy Vicious Grows. Episode 8 of the Wake and Blaze podcast. Now, I got notes because I'm fancy. Guys. Check this out. Notepad. Actually, let's bring it up right here because I got it saved. Boom. Notepad. Talk about the light, almost harvest. Got notes, man. We doing good. We're coming prepared this time. I'm feeling good today, man. I'm feeling healthy. I'm getting over a cold. This cough is finally fucking going away, man. And I can taste food again, you know. Don't you hate being sick and you can't taste food? That is the worst thing in the world, man. I mean, maybe not the worst thing in the world, but you know what I mean? It's up there. Smoking on some purple punch, and let me tell you what, it is not purple, and it is not punchy at all. The plant that I cut two plants down because it was it was getting messed up by some sort of bug or something, man. But the nugs and everything look great. They smell great. Everything is good. Not, like, no complaints, really. It's just, like, the taste, actually. That's my only complaint. Let's see here. Very frosty. It's got a nice look to it. That's it. I've been curing it in this jar for a couple of days. Just keeping it nice and airtight. High from Pismo Beach. Just got a little bit in there. That way I can just like kind of, it's, I mean, I have smoked a blunt out of it already, but it was, this thing was stuffed full. But honestly, when you're trying to cure something, don't stuff it full. That way it just has a little bit more air to breathe in there. Because you're, oh man, this thing's actually not even airtight all the way right now. Okay, we're good. We good. I don't know. So, I mean, all the purple punches that I still haven't cut down, they are turning purple. They are changing colors. Actually, I don't want to play that because I don't want to get copyrighted. Anyways, so the plants that I have out there right now, yes, they're turning purple, and I guarantee they will be very punchy. Call them Mike Tyson, if you will. I just really hope that they don't have a bad taste, man. Like, I'm so picky on the way my flower tastes. And, yeah, man, like, you should be too. Honestly, you should be too, man. Because if you're not picky with how your weed tastes, then what are you doing? You smoke anything? On that, though, it is almost harvest. Usually the second week of October is when people start to like cutting. Everything's about prime and ready. The purple punch will be ready. The double tangy might be ready. But that blue Skittles that's out in the garden, that is not going to be ready till next year. I'm telling you right now, it's not going to be ready till next year. And you're going to count me on that. Because I'll go out there and I will still be doing updates until that plant finishes. And it will be literally next year. It is taking forever. It's going to get rained on. It's probably going to get mold on it. The winds already broke a bunch of branches off a lot of plants. Like, all of the plants don't look as beautiful as they once were. Yes, they're still beautiful, but like on a scale of 1 to 10, they're like 7s or 6s now. You're not getting into the club anymore. You know what I mean? You're not on the list anymore. You're not getting into the club. You're not a 10 anymore. You're a 6. You go to the back of the line. Harsh reality, but that's how it is. I don't know if you can see these. I got totes right here behind me. These totes are where it's at, man. These HDX totes from Home Depot. Not a sponsor, nothing like that. No ad. I think they're like 9 or 10 bucks, man. Let me show you. I got two of them right there. They're like, I forget how many gallons they are. Maybe 30? 30 or so? It's got Blue Knight in there, and it's got Purple Punch in there right now. But, yeah, the Purple Punch that I cut down, it is, it's not where I want it to be. So I think we're going to trim that up and donate it. We're chilling, man. Big chilling. Hope everyone's doing good, feeling good, looking good. Most importantly, smelling good. Please keep up on your personal hygiene. I don't want to smell you when I'm out in public. All right, should we talk about...
Searching for music for your next video?
Okay, big coughs, big coughs. That's all right. That's how you know we're getting somewhere. Let's play another song. To be honest, I didn't even think I would make it to episode 8. But here we are, episode 8. Thank you guys for chilling, relaxing. Much appreciated. I just like having on some tunes in my headphones a little bit. I love music, man. Music is a very big part of my life. I like playing the guitar. I do write. And, yeah, man. Yeah, I love music. I've only been to, like, 2 concerts. No, 3 concerts. I've been to Ozfest. I was like 14. And what's cool about Ozfest, man, like, I like rock. My dad listened to rock, like AC/DC, Metallica, et cetera, et cetera. I listened to rock as a kid. Like, mainly he listened to Tool. If you guys know who Tool is, it's a weird rock band, but they make some really, like, you know, they make a couple hitters for sure. My personal preference now is just definitely hip hop and rap and alternative. Sublime and the Dirty Heads, etc., etc. Anyway, so I went to Ozfest, and Ozfest at the time was sponsored by Monster. And like when I was like 13 or 14, that's all I wore. Like I had a Monster hat. Call me Kyle, right? Had a Monster hat. Had a Monster shirt. I just had everything Monster, you know. I was a typical Kyle. Yes, my name is not Kyle, guys. My name is Ty. You just call me Ty or Vicious, all right? Not Kyle. Not a Kyle. Promise you. Anyways. I had Monster gear on. And staff walks up to me. Hey, what are you doing? I said, what do you mean? What am I doing? Like 14, kind of like nervous, you know? And I was with my buddy, too. And my buddy never really talked that much. He was just kind of like, he was like, I'm Jay. And he was Silent Bob. You know what I mean? I'm always bullshitting, kind of. And he just never said anything. He kind of looked at me. And like, I could tell by the way he was looking at me. He was like, yeah. Or nah. Yay or nay, pretty much. Staff walks up to me and goes, what's up, man?
how many people are you with? Right off the bat, and I'm like, huh? What do you mean, how many people am I with? Kind of weird, right? I said, I'm with like 8 or 10 people, because it was like my mom's ex-boyfriend. He took me, and he had all of his boys with him, like a bunch of friends. And including me, including me and my friend, you know what I mean? So it's probably like me and him plus like 8 other people. So like definitely 10 people. And I told him, yeah, I'm like with like 8 to 10. So then he like grabs these tickets and just rolls them out. Boom, boom, rolls them out. Long story short, he gives me 10 all access passes to go backstage. And if I didn't want to watch backstage, I can go to the very front spot 2 feet away from Ozzy. So I come back to like my mom's boyfriend at the time. And I go, hey, man, check this out. Boom. Hold up all the tickets. They're like, what is that? You know, like, you get some snacks or something, like free snacks or something. I'm all, these are all access passes, man. And they just lose their mind. Because, right, you, I didn't even want to go. I have really bad social anxiety. And I always have had really bad social anxiety. And I just didn't want to go. Like, I was low-key just fucking scared. Like, it was like, in my head, like, it was going to be crazy off the hook, right? But that's just in your head. When you get there, it's actually not that bad. You know what I mean? Like, that's the thing with anything. If you start overthinking in your head, man, it impacts me a lot, like almost daily. Like, I won't even hop on a plane because, I mean, it's just like thoughts run through my head, right? But like, my wife wants to go somewhere, wants to go to LA or to Vegas. Like, I got to get over that fear, man. I got to stop thinking in my head so much. So just like, do me a favor. Don't be like me and let like little things like even driving, man. Like, I don't mind driving at all. I think I'm a good driver. I don't, you know, I've only been pulled over one time and that's it in my entire, I mean, I've had my license 12 years. And I know some people don't even get pulled over their entire lifetime, but like, I mean, no excuse. I was in a hurry. I did a California stop, highway patrol. Whoop. He said, why are you running the stop sign? I said, look, man, I'm just trying to get to my grandma's house to go check on her. And, yeah, he didn't even give me a ticket. He's like, oh, I respect it. He gave me a fix-it ticket because I didn't have a front license plate. And in California, you have to have a front and back license plate. I didn't have the front one. So he had to, like, you know, it was one or the other. You want to get a driving point on your record for doing a Cali roll, or do you want, you know, just a little $25 fix-it ticket, go get a license plate, and wait in the DMV for 75 hours. So I waited in the DMV for 75 hours, got a license plate, paid $25. We out. I brought the backstage passes back to my mom's ex. We're going back to the story now. And we go behind stage. Ozzy's there. He's talking. I think he was like, honestly, he wasn't even smoking or doing any like drugs or anything like that. I mean, just for the fact, because he's doing it. He's done it for 85 years. And, oh man, long story short, I had a great time. I got backstage passes, which I didn't think that was going to happen. I didn't want to go. I seen titties, and I was like 14, so that was cool. I had a good time. That was fun. I think that was a good time for sure. And then another concert that I went to was the Dirty Heads in Chico, California. I've seen the Dirty Heads 2 times, and the Dirty Heads are awesome. If you guys like Sublime, check out the Dirty Heads. They're just like Sublime, kind of. And actually, I shouldn't even say they're like Sublime. They're their own music. But I found them years and years ago off the Sublime playlist. And I've listened to them since. My wife loves them. It's just like the type of music that you're chilling on the beach with your lady. There's a song called Lay Me Down. Check out that song. It's called Lay Me Down by the Dirty Heads. It's like a Bonnie and Clyde. They're on the run. And it's just super catchy. That's the song that got me into them. And, yeah, be sure to check that out. Lay Me Down at the Dirty Heads. It's a good song. Great song. Yeah, but almost harvest, though, you know? Everyone likes to cut the second week of October. And like I said, the Blue Skittles isn't going to be done till next year. I know I say that as a joke, but I really believe that it's not going to be even done till, like, the first week of November, man. Second week of November. Is there any like anyone else out there that have strains out there that are running like really, really behind? Because that is me, man. That's the blue Skittles right now. The purple punch is wrapping up. The trichromes are getting almost to that amber point. The hairs are looking nice. It's almost about 100%. It's probably like, it's about 80-20 right now. I can go pull them out there if I wanted to right now, but it's been so cold at night. I've been wanting them just to like get those fall colors going. And like, plus it's called purple punch. It's supposed to be purple. I pulled these two plants over here the other day. Dude, you see this fly on top of my fucking, my brim of my hat? Get out of here, bro. Yeah, I just hit myself in the forehead. That probably hurt, dude. Nah, we good. We good. We good. We good. Anyways, the hell are we talking about before this damn fly landed on me? Okay, yeah, I want to leave the purple punch in there until it turns purple. But I don't want to risk, you know, I don't want, you know, at the risk of losing potency, flavor, or weight. I don't want to risk it just for the color, right? So I think not this weekend, but next weekend, we will be cutting down the purple punches, regardless of what they look like, because, hey, if they're not purple, I'm going to have to call them something else, because no one's going to believe me. And the person I got the clones from, I got the Blue Knight from. The Blue Knight was actually Blue Knight, but I don't know if this purple punch is purple punch. Stay tuned to find out, because I believe it is, but like I just don't understand why would someone lie over one strain and not the other strain. If you're gonna lie to someone, might as well lie to them about everything and never talk to them again. But I just hope personally that it is purple punch, because I mean I've never got to try it, I've never grown it, and I think for those reasons right there, that's enough. And I thought that's what I bought. You know, like I thought that's what like the clones I got. So I've been telling people all year, oh man, I got purple punch. And I tell you guys in the updates, I got purple punch. I've been telling you on the podcast, we got this. I mean, I believe all the other strains are what he said they were, because I don't know what they look like. I've never, I've seen what purple punch looked like. Obviously, it's supposed to be purple. So, well, we'll figure that out. Oh, man. Should we, all right, it's big news time. Let's do it. All right, guys. Make sure y'all can hear me real quick. Let me turn my mic up just a little bit. Mic check, mic check. All right, guys. We got a special, special package. Let me pause this really quick. We have a special, special package sent by Mars Hydro. If you guys don't know who Mars Hydro is, they are a growing company, light and tent company. Be sure to check them out on Amazon.com. Search LED Grow Light to go check out all their newest equipment. And you can check out their tents. Their tents actually look really nice, man. Looks like they're really like nice quality and stuff like that. Anyways, Mars Hydro sent me their newest TS600 light. And they reached out to me from the podcast. They seen the podcast and they liked the podcast. Shout out to Mars Hydro. Thank you guys very much for sending me this light. I want to tell you guys now that I plan on doing an indoor grow, and I'm going to be using this light along with hopefully maybe a couple other Mars Hydro lights. We'll see. We'll see. I would like to do at least, because I've never done a full LED grow before. We're going to talk about this here pretty soon. I've never done a full LED grow. It's only been HPS. All right. Got her open.
Searching for music for your next video.
I can already tell that she's like somewhat sturdy, man. All right, guys.
Mars Hydro, TS600, brand new out the box. Initial thoughts, looks nice, feels nice. Yo, I'm excited, man. Yo, they also gave us, oh, that's what's up, man, because sometimes lights don't come with these. They gave us two, or how many are in here? One, two. Yeah, two. They gave us two hooks, man, to hang your light. Dude, these are always, like, extra when you buy them anyways. Like, they never come with a light. So that's what's up. That's a huge plus in my book, man. Also comes with this Mars Hydro warranty card. Got all the information on it. It's my blunt. Seven days return, free shipping, man. Within the first 3 months from the day you receive the light, any repair needed, Mars Hydro will cover at all cost incurred. In the first year, Mars Hydro cover free repair services and parts on 1 year on and one-way shipping. Over 1 year, buyer covers all the cost. So you have 1 year, man, to email them, talk to them if anything goes wrong with the product, which is really awesome. Cool. Spectrum test report. That's cool. Shows the wavelengths, the input voltage, the coverage area. So the coverage area on this would be a 2 foot by 2 foot. So if I wanted to do my 4x4 tent, which I have already, I would just need one more of these. And these retail at $89.99. So if you grab two of these, you'll be able to do a 4x4 area, no problem. Also, instructions. Pretty self-explanatory. If you guys know how LED lights work, pretty self-explanatory. Now my only question is, because with LEDs, I know different lights do different things. So I know the red lights is more for flower, the blue lights are more for veg. And I've only had one other light, and it allowed me to change the colors on the LEDs. So that is the only question that I have with this one, is if we're able to change the colors or... It says photosynthesis speaking, plants need a lot of red and blue to help growing and flowering. So this test shows that the LED grow light spectrum contains a lot of red and blue. Besides, we do add some others. Sometimes there's like some greens and yellows in there as well. Let me get some other tunes going up in here. I'm digging these tunes. Oh, it's Espanol. All right, so let's plug it in. Oh my gosh! Woo! That is some brightness, man! I don't even think I can show y'all this. Woo! That is so bright!
Yeah, that's right. Look how bright that is, though, man. I can't show you guys because I'll blind you.
Woo!
Oh! All right, I gotta turn it off. That is so bright, guys. Okay, so, first things first, that light is bright as shit. Very bright. Wow. That only covers a 2x2 area? Are you sure that thing don't cover a 20x20 area? Like, no way. Wow, man. That thing is bright. That's, so, I mean, other than that, man, other than I don't think I can change the colors on it, which is fine because that one doesn't look like I need to change the colors on it. Yeah, I don't think we need to change the colors on this thing, man. I think it's already providing enough output light, and it's got a little bit of reds in there. The reds are more for flowering, in my opinion. I feel like the only thing that would make this light better is a remote to change colors, but I don't even really think we need to. So overall, I'll give this light like a 9 out of 10 just for the fact of how bright it is, how sturdy it is. The warranty card, that's awesome. The price point, would I buy it? Yes, I would buy it. I probably will buy another one. I say another one like I bought this one. I probably will buy one to add with this one. Awesome, man. I'm stoked. Yo, shout out to Mars Hydro for sending me a dope product. I can't wait to use it. I'm going to throw this in the indoor grow ASAP. But the question is, I think I might have to buy two more. Because the way my banking account is set up, the way I want to set up the indoor run is I kind of want to make like, it's just like a square missing one spot. So it's just two L's. Pretty much just like this, and have the plants run along this side here, run along the back wall, side wall, and that way I can just walk in and have free roam, easy to water, easy to access, and I can just run the plants just in L shapes, just boom, L. So I would need like four. And if I had four, I would be able to do an 8x8 area, and I feel like an 8x8 area would be perfect. I feel like that would be perfect, man. Shout out to Mars Hydro again. Thank you very much for reaching out and watching the podcast. I hope I did the product justice, man. I'm very excited to use this thing. When I plugged it in initially, I was not expecting it to be that bright. Holy. Holy. Yo, guys, like literally, not like, okay, no ad, nothing. Okay, now this is just me. This is me. That light is fucking bright, man. That light is almost as bright as one of my fucking HPS 1000s. And that's a 600. That's all I'm saying. That was the big news, guys. That was the big news for me. I never had a company reach out to me before. And I was very excited to work with this company, man. So, thank you. Thank you very, very, very much. Much appreciated. On top of that, tomorrow is my 4-year marriage anniversary. And what's cool about that is I could say 10-4, good buddy. And I'll always remember my anniversary day because it's 10-4. It's 10-4. Yo, if I forget that, then draw up the papers. Anyways, yeah, so I'll probably be celebrating our 4-year marriage anniversary together. We've been together 6 years in total. And I couldn't ask for anything better, man. Honestly, I could say that my wife has changed my life for the better. Who knows where I would be without her. And that's where I'm going to leave that. Because if I didn't have her, I'd probably be somewhere I shouldn't be. or getting into trouble, just like I was before I met her. So, she hold me down. Hopefully, I do the same for her. And yeah, man. We gonna keep on pushing. Keep on keeping on. Now, I got this new phone. And I still have the same phone number that I get texts and calls for this chick named Denise. I'm not Denise, man. Now, I'm gonna answer this. Hello?
Congratulations. We have some exciting news for you. You now qualify for government subsidy.
Pay your student loans, people. Because then I get the call for it. I ain't paying your student loan. Also, I want to dive into some YouTube videos. And then we'll go watch some funny videos, maybe, possibly. We're running out of blunt time. And talk about the news. And a couple other growing companies that I want to talk about. So, let's just dive right into it. The first company I want to check out is TNB. All right. Is it T? Nah. TNB. There's nothing better. Grow company. TNB Naturals. There we go. So on the last podcast, this company, TNB, stands for There's Nothing Better, reached out to me, or Loki kind of reached out to me, said they wanted to kind of do a video together. And I'm more than willing to do a video because, like I said, I want to do an indoor run, and it looks like a lot of their products are for indoors, which would be great. So it'd be like a win-win for both of us. I can use their products and I could show them on the podcast, which would be great. There's no issues with that. The TNB Naturals Enhancer Growth Video Natural CO2 Generator. So it looks like I've seen a video before. It has like a bottle. I think it's just filled with CO2. You literally shake it, pop a hole in it, and then you just set it in the room. I think it covers like a decent amount of square footage. Dude, I'm ready.
Boss, I write the Grow Book and Equipment Guide, and this is the TNB CO2 Enhancer. And
I've heard about this Grow Boss guy before.
Indoors, for sure, you're going to need a bottle of this in your garden. Because once you turn that light on, there's nothing you can add that will get you more weight than CO2.
CO2 is a big weight producer.
But CO2 and water in the photosynthesis equation. So keep watching, because I'm going to show you exactly why you need...
Dude, those plants are a little too tall for your room, bro. Okay, let's go to TNB's actual site, YouTube page.
Hey, everybody. Well, I got another amazingly beautiful day here in BC. It's raining like crazy outside.
I think TNB Naturals is based out of Canada.
I thought I'd give you a quick update today on my indoor grow tent at work at Pacific Northwest Garden Supply. So I'm a pretty lucky guy. I get to come here to work and have garden tents to play with and everything like that.
That's awesome, man. What a job. That'd be an awesome job.
Because I'm going to be setting a couple of these guys off here.
Yeah.
These CO2 enhancers. They're from TNB Naturals. They're awesome, guys. I've used them at home, but anyway, I was sealing this tent up, and gonna start running these. I'd been getting email from guys wanting to know, like, hey, can you run CO2 in tents? Yeah, it's great. Anyway, so these are what I'm gonna be running today. Now, I met Josh at the Pacific Northwest Garden Supply Vendors Week, and I had a great time with Josh. He's a great guy.
On my lucky day. Stan couldn't be here, but I've got...
Oh, he's from Green Planet, and this guy's from TNB.
Guys, check out Jeremy. He's the one that does the green, nice front ends. He did my last one, actually, so give him a shout. And I'm here today. We've got Josh on.
Okay. This guy's just unboxing. TNB Naturals. All right, let's check this out. There's one video that I really wanted to show you guys. Shake daily for optimal performance. Oh, so you have to shake it up daily? Are you just hanging it in your room? Or can you like set it somewhere? Hey, that's sick. I like that, man. Man, there was like a video that I really, I watched it from them and like explaining them what they're all about and everything. All right, guys, so we're going to move on to the news part of the podcast. We're just going to be finishing up here. Going to be checking out what's popping off in the marijuana industry. I like to do this on every podcast. And we just kind of just hang out and check the news that matters to us. You feel me? All right. Cannabis has gone from a criminalized drug to a multi-billion dollar global boom in just a few years. Here's everything you need to know about the emerging legal cannabis industry. It's a good looking nug. Legal cannabis is one of the world's newest, most dynamic industries since Colorado legalized the drug in 2012. The previously illegal plant has birthed multi-billion dollar public companies, minted billionaires, and brewed social change not since the end of Prohibition. Yeah, cannabis is looked at a lot differently now. CBD boom, we talked about that in like one of the first podcasts. CBD and hemp are about to take over the entire industry altogether. That's a no cap. Move this water. Cannabis industry. This is posted 2 hours ago. Insiders are optimistic legal weed can pass later this year. Where? In New Jersey? More than 200 insiders and people interested in getting a start in New Jersey's growing cannabis industry gathered to talk about the expanding medical marijuana program, trends in CBD and hemp. What'd I just say? And if lawmakers will vote to legalize marijuana later this year. NJ Cannabis Insiders, a live fall event took place at New Jersey Convention and Exposition Center in Edison Wednesday. NJ Cannabis Insider, a weekly subscriber-based newsletter produced in New Jersey Advanced Media, yada yada. So New Jersey's trying to get popping off here. Respect it. Right on. Underbanked cannabis industry struggles to finance double-digit growth. Oh, man, really? Does that mean, like, banks don't want to work with cannabis companies? All right, so here's the key points. Though medical recreational use of marijuana is now legal in 33 states, marijuana is still classified as a Schedule I substance under federal law, putting it in the same category as heroin, LSD, and ecstasy. Most financial institutions such as banks, Visa, and MasterCard will not work with the cannabis industry, fearing federal prosecution. So yeah, no bank wants to be associated with the cannabis industry. And that is something else, which is not going to stop the cannabis industry. Everything could be done by cash by simply going to pull cash out of an ATM. And you normally see an ATM in cannabis stores probably for that reason. Crazy, man. Let's read this right here. Limiting financing options. As the cannabis industry grows, the shortage of financial services for cannabis companies has become more of a headache. Research from New Frontier Data estimates that the legal cannabis market was worth $10.5 billion in 2018. Total legal sales of cannabis are projected to grow 16% over the next 6 years, reaching $29 billion by 2025.
Damn.
Billion-dollar industry. Get started now. I feel like it's only going to get harder. It's either going to get harder or easier. Wow. Crazy. Damn, the future of cannabis. Oh, is that Gary V? Oh, we gotta listen to Gary V, man.
If you ever buy anything.
Gary V is awesome. Entrepreneur, made billions.
The cannabis industry is ahead of almost every other industry because of its general youth and purebred entrepreneurship. You got your perspective. I just want to be happy. Don't you want to be happy?
Yeah.
I love starting with the macro and then going into the micro. You know, my college friends are going to laugh their asses off that I'm on the cover of your magazine because literally their four-year quest in college was to get me to smoke a blunt with them. Right? So this is unbelievably deja vu for me. I grew up not drinking beer or wine or alcohol, yet I became an unbelievable expert at 15, 17, 19, 21, 23 on the consumer of that product, right?
All right, I don't want to steal content or anything like that, so we're going to – I mean, I love Gary V. If he talks about the future of the cannabis industry, it's got to be good. Be sure to check this video out, all right? I don't want to get copyrighted or anything like that. Some of these other small channels and stuff like that, we can pull clips from. No big deal. Someone as big as Gary V, probably getting, you know, copyright and stuff like that. Like CBS News, like, I don't know if I could play that type of stuff, you know what I mean? But I want to. Yahoo Finance looks at the future of cannabis.
I don't think there's really a better time to be doing a special like this as Illinois and their state legislature.
That guy is high as hell.
First in the country to pass a bill legalizing the sale and possession of cannabis. Many other states legalizing marijuana in other ways, perhaps through ballot initiatives. But guys, how much does that fact say about how far we've come when we're talking about cannabis?
It says a lot about my home state, Illinois. But, you know, when we...
Okay, she tries to hide that she smokes weed. You can just tell by her attitude. Cannabis benchmarks, Colorado wholesale spot price. What is this?
A lot of issues you can think about right now that are bipartisan.
No, this may be the only one.
Well, just think about the job creation. I mean, in 2018 alone, there were 64,000 new jobs created in the cannabis industry. So
wow.
That's just a really compelling political strategy to begin with.
Mm-hmm. But I mean, when we talk about a candidate kind of separating themselves from the pack, Gillibrand coming out with a 5-point plan and saying, this is really what I want to focus on.
What the hell? I mean, that's not hard to believe, but that's awesome, man. Let me fix this, guys. Okay, so I know you guys can't see the prices, right? But I'm gonna tell you guys the prices. Tobacco market size is $785 billion, leading number one. Tobacco is still number one. Fast food is $617 billion. Number two is fast food. Number three, beer, $593 billion. And then right after that, cannabis, $344 billion. Under that, we beat wine at $302 billion. Now, I feel like beer and wine should be in the same category. Don't understand. But, okay.
As she moves forward with her campaign, of course, we've seen other candidates.
Okay, it's getting, like, political and shit, and I'm not about that. No politics on the podcast. We keep it light. Sometimes we talk about the bad shit. Sometimes we talk about good shit. You know how we do. California's new 2019 cannabis laws explain pot convictions and marijuana marketing. Oh, okay.
As California's marijuana marketplace continues to grow, lawmakers continue to look for new ways to regulate it. The start of 2019 brought two new cannabis-related laws to California. Let's break them down. Here's the first one, Assembly Bill 1793, which speeds up the process for people who may be eligible to get convictions related to marijuana dismissed.
Like
the
myself.
The bill requires the Department of Justice to automatically reduce or dismiss certain cannabis-related charges by July 1st, 2020. Here's a more detailed timeline tweeted by the group Code for America. Supporters of the law...
Hey, go back. Okay, before July 1st, 2019... Run statewide Prop 64 eligibility check for all case in CLETS. Whatever, CLETS, it's an abbreviation for something. Notify district attorneys in each county of the cases that are potentially eligible for Prop 64. Review all potentially eligible cases. Decide whether to grant or challenge each case.
Supporters of the law say it will help save law enforcement resources and could reduce prison overcrowding.
Well, yeah.
Now, the second cannabis-related law that took effect in 2019 deals with marketing marijuana to anyone under the age of 21.
Okay.
Basically,
well, that's
adult use of marijuana.
That's
restricts advertisers from marketing.
That's going right now. You have to be 21.
Some loopholes. AB 3067 closes those. The new law adds
I should say that's
cannabis,
an effect.
Cannabis products, cannabis businesses, or anything designed for cannabis use to the list of products and services that cannot be marketed to minors online. It also prohibits businesses from using anyone under the
crazy from age 21,
age
right?
of 21
in yeah to work there. Yeah, I know that. Awesome, man. All right, guys, that's it for the news. Thank you guys for watching very much. I hope you guys have a great rest of your week, great rest of your day. Make sure to stay blazed, and I will catch you on next week's podcast, episode 9. I will see you there. Later.